He's a stonemason, man.
Yes, sir.
What's the difference of this meat?
That is sick, man. That is absolutely sick.
Nice one. It's made out of mouse tails and intestines and lungs and ears.
What?
Yeah, oh, meat. Oh, mate, I'm just going to do this all to you. Yeah, you're going to end up on my YouTube channel, mate. Fucking...
Nah,
I... this has got a mouse's body there, a mouse's back legs, chameleon arms, that's a crab's body, and then I made it a wig out of a mouse's rib cage.
What do you mean, this crab body there?
That head, the head of it there, that's a crab's body.
Yeah, what? Where did you get that idea from?
I don't know, man. My head's mangled. Look at this one, this is snake. It's a ladder I've made out of snake, dead snake. Just a little fun thing.
Yes, man.
What do you reckon to fish with hands?
Fish with... Is that how the world started, yeah?
Yeah, mate, that's how they pulled themselves out of the water, innit? Otherwise they'd be stuck in there. It was the ones with hands that got out first. Here's a baby snake cuddling a baby mouse with its mouth.
Oh my.
But what about this, mate? What about this? A Jesus lizard.
Holy shit, man.
Yeah. You got this fella here, which is that's a goldfish with lizard arms and lizard legs. And I think these would be the pets. In an ideal world, these would keep these as pets.
What is that on the left?
This one, that's a baby chicken's head with its skin peeled off. And then I've attached it to the body of a lizard. So it looks like it's in its mother's womb.
That's jokes, son.
It's like a stick man, but made with fish and mouse legs.
What the fuck?
Yeah. That's a dragon. Well, I think it looks like a dragon. It's got a rat's head. I've chopped the end of the back of the rat's head off. Put a rat's spine coming out of it. Some wings and some feet.
Yeah, man. Shit, man. How long did these take you to build?
Like this box of stuff here is like a week and a half, mate. Of like 10, 11 hours a day. Of skinning the stuff, of prepping the stuff, defrosting it, laying the resin. It takes a while, man. So for the lovers, a little loads of mouse intestine, I love that. And I try and spread the blood out and the juice out as well.
Special edition for Valentine's Day, mate.
Yeah, well, people could have a second Valentine's Day, innit, now? They're already inside, they missed their anniversary a couple of years ago. You forgot Valentine's Day with the bird or whatever. Have a second one, mate, while you're locked in the house. Make up for all the things you've forgotten.
All the fucking Valentine's you've forgotten.
Yeah. Even for all the ones you forgot with your exes, mate, make up for it with the new one. Don't sell it.
That's jokes, man.
Here's a fish with hands and legs. It's got little spines there. It's like a little bottom feeder fish with feet and arms.
Is that a sucker fish?
Yeah, man, it's a pleco.
Yeah, man, that's sick. That's absolutely sick.
Nice one, sir. A man with no regular hat. The dragon, which dragon? Do you mean... Oh, you want... This guy's on the website still, I think, man. If he's not, if you can't find him on there, give us a shout and I'll put him up. I'm not dead sure what this is on the website because I was pretty tired by the end of me fucking... mad week sniffing fucking resin fumes and dead shit, so I was pretty tired. Here's a snake, I chopped its head off, and then I put its head into a wheel.
So you got love bits of snake.
Yeah, and I love that, so it's like it's eating itself. But if you don't look at it like dead close, you can't really tell that's not a mouth.
I was going to say, that just looks like a string going round, bro, to be honest.
Yeah, that's what I was hoping for, bro.
That's sick, man.
Yeah. What else do we have? There's a rat's head, just with the back of its head and its brain sucked out, so you can see inside where the brain would be. I wanted this to look like a rocket going through the sky. It's a fish, and I chopped its arse off, and kicked its foot up its arse. And I thought it looked like a rocket soaring through the sky. They don't want the bigger bubbles in there so they look like stars in the distance. I don't know if that's that obvious to everyone else.
That's dope, son. You're building much more now than you're in isolation.
Nah, man, I can't really. There's laws and that around doing all this. You can't do this in a domesticated house.
Really?
Yeah, you got to do it from a work studio. What about you, work-wise? How's it going for you?
Dead, mate. Dead.
Good. You still working with James?
No, I'm working with his dad.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, man.
Sick.
Sick, man.
Yeah, he's a good guy, isn't he?
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. He's like a fucking Yoda, you know what I mean?
Is he? He's probably knowledgeable.
Yeah, man. He knows everything as well. He knows bare shit.
Is
he? Yeah, bare shit.
See?
Yeah, man.
How are you anyway with all this going on? Like, you're not seeing like your family and obviously because you're in England, I'm guessing.
Yeah, well, family's obviously over in Spain, isn't it? Or lockdown as well, so.
That's what I mean. You alright with all that?
Yeah, it is what it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, I wish I could be over there, helping them out and shit, but at the same time, like, it's bad over there, mate. Like, fucking NHS over there is like a border collapse, you know what I mean?
Shit. No, I didn't know that. Hopefully it's not happening here. You're fucking...
No, there's some cases already in Bedford.
Is it? Yeah. I think we've got 5 in Plymouth.
You said that I'm in Plymouth?
Yeah. Say it down there, man. Fucking, it's hotter. The weather's better. I met a girl. It's nice. It's
nice. You know that, mate. I found down here. That's it, mate. Oh, that's jokes, man. When all this is up there, yeah, we'll fucking meet up in that, man, definitely.
We should, man, we should. I've not seen you for years.
Years, mate. Fucking years.
Since I think it was at Paddy's house and you walked through the door and dived on me. Years ago, man, that was a long time ago.
We're talking about maybe six, seven years?
Yeah, something like that, bro. Fucking... Life happens, don't it, mate? It gets in the way and you move away and that.
You know that, mate.
You don't even think about it at the time. It's mad, mate. It's mad to think that was probably the last time I saw you lot as well.
That's crazy. And then you went to Japan and that, mate. And then got creative and got started doing this shit. Like
got
that.
Sober, bro. I got sober. That's where all this started.
Sober. Oh, shit. Sober Jack.
Do you want to see a lizard's arsehole?
Yeah, man. Go on then.
Look there, see that little line there?
Yeah.
That's what it shits from.
That's mad.
Isn't it? that's just a dead fish. I ran out of feet. I put all the feet in key rings. So, one sec, I'm trying to find a foot. Fucking hell. Yeah, so I put all the feet and key rings instead for people. But I forgot to put them on my fish.
That's smart.
This was supposed to be a Virgin Mark, but it's a Virgin Mary instead. I normally put testicles inside, didn't it? It's a Virgin Mary. But I like to put a pair of bollocks in there, but I ran out of bollocks as well.
That's sick, man. Right. How long did that take you to carve that? That looks like it took you ages.
Oh, mate, no, it's from a mould, man. That's a mould, that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, mate, if I was carving them, it would take a lot longer to make these. Jesus, I'd still be sat there now going mental.
I know.
And imagine the mind you'd have to have, mate. Imagine the mind you've carved that out of a rectangle or something, like to carve that out of that shape.
Nah.
I'd have to be delusional, mate, to be like, oh, yeah. I'm going to put a house design in the square and carve it into a Virgin Mary. Get locked away, bro. Locked away. Here's another fish with legs. Like a kangaroo fish.
Kangaroo fish.
Here's a millipede bumhole. Big, innit? Man, that's the end of the fucking millipede, bro.
That's mad.
Innit? They fucking stink as well, you know. All the mad stuff I cut up in that. That was the worst smell of everything, bro. Because all the way through, from like the head to the arse, it's literally just like one long intestine. It's just full of shit all the way through. Fucking hums. Like, I've got a strong stomach in it as a butcher for like fucking 8 years, and now I chop up animals for fun. But that turned my fucking stomach, mate. Just so that I could attach it. I just did that so that I could attach it to the... Attach the head of it to some, a two-headed lizard that I made. That looks like a ghost lizard.
That looks like the fucking thing out of Harry Potter, mate.
I've never watched it, bro. I never got into Harry Potter.
That dog thing with the three heads in it.
Oh, like fucking Cerberus or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. What else have I got here? Trying to show you stuff you might not have heard. Well, did you see this one? That's a leopard gecko's head attached to a clown roach's body. And then I've shoved fossils into the top of its mouth so it looks like it's got some dirty teeth.
That's mad.
Yeah, thank you.
That's sick, man.
Nice one, bro. What's that one? Baby chameleons. Something fancy, you know. If you're not liking the weird stuff, you can have a baby lizard.
But, you know...
Hey?
That's mad. What? You just had it, like... Where'd you get it from?
Pet shop. Fucking... I buy that many dead mice and rats from there. Initially, before I was going to kill whatever pet I had. And they were like, what is it you're feeding with all these? You shouldn't be buying this many a week and going through them. What? How many things are you feeding? I was like, nah, mate, I don't feed anything with these. I feel the snap them to my pencil cases. Which got the same reaction, bro. Eh?
What was the answer to that?
Well, they just thought it was fucking weird. And then they were like, well, we've got this bag of dead lizards in that. Do you want them? I was like, yay! I'll stick all the lizards on crucifixes because Easter was coming up at the time. Don't want to make something for Easter.
That's fun! That is sick, man.
Yeah,
that's sick.
The other stuff I've got here is just like fish in that. Like different style, another chameleon, just little bits of fish. I got these. It kind of looks like a fanny in a way, but it's a rock with a mouse's heart stuck inside it.
Like a fanny.
It does so, doesn't it? Like you've got a little clip of hair at the top.
Oh, I love your way of thinking, Jack. I miss you. I miss that way of thinking, bro.
You got this as well. This is probably. I tried to do one thing that was artistic, and I showed it to my girlfriend. She doesn't get it. She thinks it's just stupid. But and everyone else seems to think it doesn't make sense either. Because I didn't realise that you could make it to be this way, which is what I did. But if you turn it that way, it doesn't look like what I thought it looked like. But I've called it pause, because it looks like a pause symbol, innit?
It does, yeah!
But it's made of fish, mate, and fish don't have feet, so fish don't have paws, and I thought that'd be this whole ironic, artistic thing. But apparently it just sounds mental. Plus, if you turn it sideways and display it wrong, it's just an equal sign with some fish, and it don't make any sense.
No, I get the pause bit, I don't get the equal bit, though.
Fair, man, you're on my side, then, fucking Team Jack, me.
Team Jack.
Do you want to see a mouse's arsehole now?
Go on, then.
So far. Here's a mouse's arsehole, mate, in a ring. So if you've got that special someone in your life, you know, and you're like, you know what, I really want to... Because some women won't let you, like, fuck them up the arse, innit, until you propose to them, at least.
Or are you saying to them,
Here,
you are,
so
I love you.
Yeah, you're an asshole, but I love you. Here's a diamond ring, you want to start. But my thing with it, man, is it's a ring in a ring for a ring.
It's a ring for a ring, bro. Oh, this is brutal. This is the best day of fucking quarantine I've had so far, mate.
Sick, man. Are you on your own with it?
Nah, I've got my mates from fucking Spain, living with me now, yeah.
That's all right, isn't
it?
Mm. How long have they been over?
Adam's only been here like a fucking 2 months and he's fucking already he's been 2 months and he's been locked in the house and he's not going nowhere. He's like, he's going insane, mate.
But my mate Charlie's been living here for like, say, so 4 years, 5 years.
That's alright, isn't it? He's acclimatised enough, then. Is it nice having him over?
Huh?
Is it good having him over? Because you used to miss him when you was at college, didn't you?
Yeah, man, sick. It's nice, isn't it? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like you're at home at your own house.
Yeah. It makes your house feel like home, innit? Having people you care about around you,
isn't it? Yeah, you know that, man.
Yeah.
You and your missus, then?
Yeah. Got a flat together and that. Even got a dog, bro. Got a dog recently.
What? Oh, shit, man. Gonna have to do it up with fucking Sam and Marcel, then.
Who's Sam and Marcel? You mean from Finney?
Nah, that's Sam. Sam from college. What? You don't remember Sam Williams?
Is that the guy that you lot brought to my house and was like, this guy's your mate from years ago and I didn't remember him?
Yeah!
Is it? Mate, I never met that guy. You brought like two guys to my house who were like, you've known these for years, what you want about? And I was like, fuck off, man. I never met these guys. What's weird to me is one of them went round to my house with Alex and Alice and Ginger Sam. There was another one with you, I think, as well, and Callie. Took some other lad there. I wasn't there, man. Like, you've just had tea with my mum and dad or something. With some fucking stranger. Who was convinced he knew me.
That was Ben.
I just figured you were just having me on. I just figured you were having me on and I just went along with it. I was like, yeah. I didn't have a fucking clue who he was, mate. If I went down with him at college, I genuinely don't remember him. Neither of them. Sam Williams or this Ben lad, mate. I don't know who they are. I don't remember much from college. I really don't. So I could have met them there. I could have seen them every day. I could have. But there's so much about being there I don't remember.
Oh, man, that's funny. That's just pure funny. Anyway, keep going through your catalogue.
Yeah. There's a mouse's spine and kidneys.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, some people think it's the dick and balls, isn't it? But I think that's just going to get guys jealous. Imagine if a mouse had a dick that long, mate. I'd be devastated, mate.
They would.
Bit of ribcage.
Ribcage?
Yeah, mouse's ribcage. They look quite nice because they're pink and you can see the bones through them when you hold it up to the sunlight.
That's very small.
Different types of intestine. So that's closer to the arsehole because it's darker. Closer to the mouth end. Well, the stomach end because it's lighter in colour.
You get shitloads of people buying that, I think.
Not shitloads, nah, but fucking. It's like working a full time minimum wage job except you do more hours, but you've not got a boss and you enjoy yourself, if that makes sense. So, you know.
Yeah, I know.
I'd rather do this than work in a shop. Like, I worked in a computer shop for a while, innit, when I first started living down here after uni. Before that, you'd have loved me when I was doing this, mate. I was working door to door selling windows and doors. Oh, mate, dream job, mate. It was my dream job.
Right.
Because it's so hard. Do you know what? I've never tried.
Have you ever
tried to sell someone a door whilst they're already... At least when you're selling someone like a TV or a computer, they're not stood next to their TV or computer. When you're selling someone a front door, they're stood next to their front door and they can see everything that's not wrong with their front door. Well, hard, bro. It's like selling fucking... It's like trying to sell shit to a shovel, mate. It's fucking... But it was fun though. I worked for about two months. And for about a month of it, I had my own little team underneath me. On my first day, he sent me out on the phone. He had me on the phones at first. And apparently, because I was ringing loads of people around in Devon, my accent sounds quite confrontational, innit, and aggressive. Especially on the phone, if you can't see my face and that I'm smiling and that. I always sound angry. So I was talking to people like, you're right, mate. I'm from Devaney Home Improvements. I don't know if you've ever heard of us, but we sell windows, doors, kitchens, lists, all the stuff. But apparently I sounded really nasty and aggressive, and the manager was getting phone calls back saying, some northern lads just rang me claiming to be a local business, and it just sounds like he's going to come round to my house if I don't bar the doors. And you know what the manager did, mate? The manager went, right, look, you can't stay on the phones, because I think you'll ruin us if you stay on the phones. So what I'm going to do is, from tomorrow, you're on the doors, you're knocking doors, you get paid a little bit more, but I trust you to do it. And off you go. The first house I knocked on with the lad that was supposed to be teaching me how to do it, he stood there, right, all fucking meek, fucking shoulders like this behind his head, and fucking, as he's talking, he's like,
hello.
No. And I was like, me? Nah. So what are you? I was like, yes, bro. I can see you locked in the gaff, mate. You want to get some brownie points with your missus? You're looking at the tip your missus is at work. And he's like, I am, yeah. Well, you see that dent there on the front door? I bet your missus notices that every single day when she comes home from work and thinks, that lazy bastard hasn't even fixed it yet. How about, and while she's out at work tomorrow, I send one of our boys over and he replaces it for you. How's that sound? And then you get brownie points, you know, and you know what brownie points mean, don't you, with your missus, you know. Like that big little smile. Mate, he loved it, bought it all. He was like, yes, yes. Took the appointment. That guy then bells the manager and goes, yeah, I was trying to teach him how to do it, but immediately as I started talking, he took over, went off script and managed to sell a front door and a window.
Mate, you're fucking that guy from Line Direct. That fucking... that doesn't advertising fucking...
But you buy when you get one free, that guy.
Yeah.
These aren't dead stuff, but I quite like them. Would you reckon to that? It's a shield, so it's crystal with a diamond core coming out of it. Nah, it's plastic.
Alright.
I might make them with real bones in the future. Fucking take ages.
Yeah, you know that. Yeah. Especially setting it all up as well.
Yeah, sticking it all together and that may be a nightmare. Just super glue your hands together with fucking bits of bone. You're over. What's happening there? There we go. Mouse's heart and a gingerbread man. these mate, look at these, there's a stegosaurus with a chicken's heart inside, a baby chicken's heart. And you can fucking, if you're adventurous, you can wear it as a nipple piercing. If you're normal, you can just wear it as a badge.
The badge one sounds better than the nipple piercing.
Here's a lizard's tail on a keyring.
A what?
Lizard's tail.
Shit.
See that? You can see the markings on him and that. Mouse's legs, mate. Mouse's legs on a keyring. I've actually kept one of these for myself, and it's a chicken's foot. It's fucking... It's pretty good.
I would have got one.
Would you?
Yeah.
Well, I'll make more of them and I'll fucking send you one. Let me try and find... I took apart a mouse's tail, mate. I took a mouse's tail apart, and I think it's the best one I've ever done. Check that, mate. Let me see if I can get it to focus. Alright, won't focus. But that's, you see it there, I pulled all of its nerves and tendons and separated. Yeah.
That's sick.
Isn't it? And for everyone else that's watching, I bargained at £3.
Yes, Jack. I love it.
I thought this
was
a
man!
It's a little robot man with mouse lungs and mouse legs inside. I call him Iron Lung.
Iron Lung! That's it.
Some butterflies there throwing in the rear view mirror. So they can bob about and poke you in the eyes as you're driving.
Mate, that would be a sick dream catcher. A couple of feathers underneath that, and that would be a sick dream catcher.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Give it a go. I had some fan mail a couple months ago. Someone sent me a bag of feathers, a rabbit scalp, and some random hip bones.
Well, there you go. Attach that to that. You can attach that to the... Yeah! You can attach that to that! There's a dream catcher.
Yeah, man. There's a chicken's heart inside a robot.
That's it.
Someone's saying, this one hits the boy. Can you see the comments below, man? I've been ignoring people, man. The favourite thing I've ever made, one hits the boy, is probably the Labrador's toaster. There's a mouse's tail without any meat or skin on it. So it's just a bone, I dried it out and peeled the meat away. Started trying to do letters as well with mouse intestines. So there's a little help. But I didn't realise that I'd done it, and it's fucking the ring goes in there, so then it became. Oh, it's just the line. Bit more rib cage, more intestine. A lot of these are now rib cage.
How do you get it all into there? Do you like put it in there and then you send them away and get them fucking sealed or something?
Nah, man, it's a resin. So it's like a liquid plastic. I have to go through about six types of plastic to find which ones work with meat and that. Because most of it heats up and cooks everything inside.
Yeah.
So I've got a couple where it's heated up so much that all the bone marrow's come out of the bones and come out like it looks like fucking. It looks like all the bones have just started coming. If you know what I mean.
So you put it all into a mold and then leave it, let it cool down.
Yeah, and then mess about with it and try and make it look stupid.
That's mad.
Some mouse ears there. There's a mouse's nose. Oh, little mouse nose. What else have we got? Another wizard's tail.
Yes, sir. Just some, here's something a bit classier, you know.
Just geodes and a keyring.
That's sick. You need to fucking dream catcher, I reckon.
Yeah, man, just put some bones in that and a waterfall. No one ever seen anything like that either, so I'm quite a cocky little saying that I get a bit of a head in myself there, no one ever fucking watches these videos. I do. Yeah, no, you've been around for quite a while. Normally I get like, I'm not complaining, but you get someone watching for like 10 minutes, and then you leave, but because of the delay, I don't see that you've left, so then I get all of their comments coming up like 2 minutes later, and I basically just end up sat here having a chat with myself. With comments out of a few minutes ago, and it's not a conversation. It's just me talking to myself. And I don't realise until afterwards, because sometimes afterwards I'll press play on the video just to see if it's uploaded properly. And then you watch it and you go, what am I saying here? Because I'll be speaking, but everyone else that's seen it has already seen the comments. So then there'll be like a 2 minute gap. The comment comes through to me, and then I answer that. But another comment comes up below, and it looks like I'm answering that, and it just becomes a clusterfuck of words. None of it makes sense no more. The rest of this is like mouse feet and intestines, you know? Little mouse paw there, something you can high five if you're a lonely guy but you still want to celebrate.
You're a lonely guy, that's jokes.
This one's a bit grim. It's, I peeled, I think it's the spine of a mouse or the leg bone of a mouse, half the leg bone of a mouse. And I peeled all the meat out of it and left it in the sun to see what would happen, and then put it in. And it's just got this really dark brown colour.
It could easily be.
I have thought about just filling with mouse poo, just squeezing the poo out of the mice, like these.
I think I was doing it, see that? That is sick. That is absolutely sick. A butcher's couple would love that, mate. That's the thing, man. I was supposed to be doing a wedding fair. Yeah, a pretty wedding fair, it's called.
It seemed like it was a big event, and I really wanted to do it, and I got accepted in that, and it was on the Sunday just gone. So two days before the isolation started, I was fucking gutted, because a lot of the stuff I've made, like these little love arts with mouse arts inside, I made loads of love-themed stuff and that. And diamonds with kidneys in. And oh, there's another, there's a little mouse of bumble in a ring.
That's it, man. Fucking coronavirus, right?
Did it?